Hey everybody, happy Saturday. How you doing? Hope you guys are doing great. It's your girl Allie. Here we are at the end of yet another week in the Chris Sain Road to 100K Challenge. You guys know I'm in year number two, trucking along, trying to get to 100K. And no, I'm not gonna stop until I get there. If you're new to the channel, you're watching Allie's View, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. Help my video get trending on YouTube. And guys, I don't have a whole lot going on in my portfolio from this last week because I actually kind of stayed away from the market for two reasons. Number one, because there's just been a lot going on. There are ways to make money both up and down, as you guys know. But I'm still working my way through this little account deficit that I've got that you'll see when you look in my portfolio, waiting for the price of some of my stocks to go back up so that I don't end up having to deal with the intricacies of another one of these little margin calls. I think I told you guys I had my first margin call about a month ago, and I'm actually gonna put a video on there on the channel here and show you guys what that experience was like for me. But guys, we're at the end of week number three in 2022. And this is my second year participating in the Chris Sain 100K Challenge. You guys know I shared with you that I took some profit during the year last year when I had some things that came up. So my portfolio got diminished a little bit, and I have a disproportionate amount of what I currently own in AMC. And shout out to the visitor here to Allie's View that was saying don't get left at the party with AMC. I kind of feel like I'm already left at the party because I said that I'm gonna hold AMC as long as I possibly can in hopes, hopes that I can actually see this thing squeeze. Guys, I know it went up to 70 some odd dollars last year, and I really made good money on that. I mean, several thousand dollars as a result of it going up like it did. And I was very pleased with the results with that. But right now it's kind of going south, and I think there's another level of support at like $12.50. So that's way down. I don't know whether I'm gonna hold it until it goes down there. I may sell and then buy back in. If it continues to drop like that. So I'm sticking with AMC, but hey, because you never know when it's going to squeeze. That's one of the things about this kind of situation. But guys, last week you might remember that I shared with you Dollar General and Microsoft, and they actually did pretty well in spite of, at least early on in the week, in spite of some of the changes. This week I have two that I want to share with you guys. One of them is DraftKings. DraftKings, DKNG, that's the ticker symbol. And then the other one is Netflix. Wow, they are really in a buyer level. And they're just two stocks that I'm looking at. And there are plenty others that you guys, I'm sure, are aware of. But those are two that I feel like are in a good position that could take off if we can get some good momentum going. Also, if you have not already considered learning about trading, how about consider taking Terry Igioma's course? There's a link in the description below. Terry is a renowned professor now, I guess you could say, or teacher of trading. She was an assistant principal, got tired of that role that she had, and decided that she wanted to start trading and traveling and be able to do that for a living and provide income and travel the world doing it. And now she's taught over 11,000 students how to trade, including me, how to identify buyer levels and seller levels, and kind of knowing how to see when banks are buying. So if you're interested in learning about technical analysis trading, how about consider Terry Igioma's course? There's a link in the description, and if you look on YouTube, you put her name in Google, you're gonna find out about her. And I think she is an outstanding teacher, and you can really learn a lot. Also, if you are interested in buying Luna, you guys know I love Luna. It is that crypto that I'm all into. And by the way, there's a video coming up probably after this one that's going to show you how to buy Luna on the Voyager app. Someone asked me whether I would do a video, so I put that together just a little while ago. So the video is coming up after this one. So I did go ahead and buy a few more Luna today, actually. And Luna is at a great price right now. It's down to like 60 some odd dollars when I came to start recording this video. you might consider buying it. I'm no financial advisor, you guys know that, but I like to make money, and if I can find ways to make money and share with you guys, I'm gonna do it. So it's your girl Allie. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. The two stocks that I'm looking at this week are DraftKings and Netflix, ticker symbol DKNG and NFLX. All right, guys, as you can see, I'm out and about today. Just wanted to make sure that I got these videos done and not let the day go by. Had some technical difficulties last week. That's why it took me a while to get my video released. But anyway, it is your girl, Allie. If you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And thank you so much for continuing to tune in with me. Let's go. Let's win. You'll see that my portfolio is down significantly. Like I said, I didn't make a lot of moves last week in this particular portfolio. I did go ahead and buy some more Voyager. And like I said, I'm trying to get buy more on Voyager of Luna. Trying to get my Luna ownership up to 125. It's your girl, Allie. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And without any further ado, hey, let's look in my portfolio. Have a great day and a wonderful weekend. I love you guys. Hey everybody, here we are inside of my portfolio. As I said, this is the end of week number 3 in the 2022 Chris Sain Challenge. You guys know I've been going with this thing since last year. I'm still trucking along. You see out there's the account deficit that I mentioned. Not a whole lot going on from an option standpoint. AMC is the big one that's kind of what I have the most ownership of in this this little portfolio here. 125 shares, and like I said, I'm thinking of potentially if it selling and then buying back in, but I'm afraid that if I do that it may decide to squeeze, so who knows. Not a whole lot going on here at this point in this particular portfolio that I've been sharing here. I'm gonna get this thing cranking again here in the next couple of days and weeks towards my goal to get to $100,000 in this portfolio. Just gotta work out a couple little things. Anyway, I like for next week, I really like DraftKings and I like Netflix. They're in a buyer level and I really think they're gonna do things. I'm no financial advisor, but you guys know I always like to share with you what I would be doing. Anyway, this is where I stand in the portfolio at this point. I'm still hoping that AMC will squeeze, and we'll see what happens. So let's go look at Voyager. Like I said, I bought some more Luna. I ended up buying some more Luna today, and you guys can kind of see where I sit with the Luna. My average cost has gone up now to $16.06 because I bought 3 Luna today, and I'm gonna put that video here on the channel so you can see. But I'm trying to get to 125, as you guys know. So this is the first time I've made another Luna purchase in a little while. Love Luna, still got over a $2,000 return on my initial investment there, up 300%. I like Luna. I think it's gonna really be a big part of our future. I'm no financial advisor, but I like to tell you guys what I'm up to. There is a link in the description if you'd like to buy yourself some Luna and use the Voyager app. Luna is really, really at a good price right now. It's at a buyer level, I feel like. I've been told that anything under $150 is a steal. So it's at like 60 some odd dollars right now since the crypto, as you all know, Bitcoin and other cryptos have kind of gone down in value over the last 24 to 48 hours. So it's impacted some of these other cryptos such as Luna. So there you have it. That's what's going on with your girl Allie. Not a whole lot. You know, I'm trying to drive both of these little portfolios on the channel here. So we will see together. Thank you all for tuning in. If you haven't already subscribed, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And without any further ado, let's go. Let's have a wonderful rest of our weekend and let's have a magnificent week in the market next week.